Hello, welcome to Atom RPG. So this is my crafting video that I've been wanting to make for a few months, but I didn't make it because, hey, I didn't know what updates will be coming, and now with all the updates, the combat balance and the new recipes, we can finally use crafting to its full potential. Before I start actually showing you the crafting, I just want to clarify a few things, and the most thing you should know is that it's actually now quite good to follow the crafted weapons per clan, because if you follow it, you have the chance to meet a caravan, which can be very, very good in the beginning, and it's basically good the whole game. The lubricator, the guns won't jam anymore, and the gun Jesus, which means 20% in crafted weapon damage. Also, you will have the hands of God, but I don't gold. I don't recommend you pick this one up, because if you get this perk, crafting no longer gives you experience. So many people that did take it were upset because, well, you can just reload your game and you will still get experience. Plus, with about 100 in tinkering skills, you won't fail that easy. And anyway, if you fail, you don't necessarily lose all the items. So I'll speak about that later. But just know that this one, it's good if it's 100%, and then you don't need to invest your points in crafting, but you don't get experience from crafting anymore. So I guess it's up to you. If you really want to use the crafting, then you can spare your skill points, because as you can see, at level 18, with 10 intelligence and also the perk to get more skill points, I still had only points enough to get rifles and shotguns to 199, speechcraft 150, bartery, and some first aid and some other skills, but that's about it. Lockpicking technology is pretty high, but I don't need it. So in case you don't want to spend all those points into tinkering, you want to take that perk. But again, you only have a limited number of craftable items and almost none of them are usable. So I really don't advise you to take that perk, because after you craft all your weapon, you won't even need the hands of gold anymore. So you can just take these weapons. And all I'm saying here is that they will be comparable to this build. So yeah, the weapons will be much, much better if you take this perk. The gun, Jesus, and lubricator. Another thing I want to clarify is, where do you buy the recipes? Well, the best crafting location, in my opinion, of course, it's here, in Paragon. You can go inside and buy items from that guy. But they also have a new trader right here, which will sell you the toolkits and some other stuff like junk and scrap. And then these guys here will sell you the recipes as well as junk and scrap and some other things like that. So it's pretty handy to just hang around here, buy the recipes from this guy, I think, the Gunnar, and the scrap and all the other things from these people around here. Another location where you can get the crafting recipes is KPZ. Krasnos Nameni, which is the bookshop. So you enter the city and it should be to the left. Enter the cities to the left, it's Abraham. Another good location to get the recipes is from the smuggler cave in the sewers. That guy that sells you the recipes and other stuff. What are you guys doing here? Go back to the car. And let's start. Before I show you the recipes, I just want to mention that I've split them. So I won't be covering armors and all of the other things or stuff that you don't really need. I will just be covering the weapons, because that's the part you're interested in. So the crafted weapons, if you take the perks, those two perks I mentioned, you can basically get end game guns in the first hour of the gameplay. Because if you craft a recipe, you don't need to have the recipe. For example, you can craft all the recipes in the game just by experimenting. So go to crafting, go to experiment, and for example, you can make even the sniper rifle just by adding the necessary components, so you don't need the recipes. Which means, technically, after 2 or 3 hours in the game, if you save and reload and do some other things, you can have weapons that are comparable to the Dragunov and other things. So they're very, very cheap, very easy to use, and all you need you to follow a certain perk line. Which I would make another one just using a crafting character, but I don't have the time. Okay, so let's start, because we have a lot of things to cover, so I'll just say the basics. I'll show you the weapons and speak about them a bit, and then we'll just show you the recipe. So, to get the percussion revolver, the best pistol in the crafting line, and as you can see, the stats are 6 to 15, but it will have no jamming chance, and it will have 20% extra damage. That means it will have something like 7 to 17, which will make it a little better than the AK, or not the AK, because that has burst far. It will make it a little bit better than the SKS, in my opinion, and if you use the 0.40 armor piercing ammunition. Besides, it will be cheap and easy to use. So you can use the pistols as a secondary arm. For example, you use a burst shot, then you just use a pistol shot. Quite efficient. So you'll have to go to the zip gun, then you have the custom revolver, then the percussion revolver, and then the percussion revolver plus. Now you can write the recipes down. It's pretty easy to write with a piece of paper because you'll have something like 1S, 1W, 1W, 1Y. Again, it's pretty easy, but you can also take a picture with your phone. So let's go to the zip gun. The zip gun is this one. It's not so hard to make, I mean, it's pretty cheap. Then you have the custom revolver. After that, you'll have the percussion revolver. And after that, you'll have the percussion revolver plus. One thing about crafting, for example, you have four components to an item, right? If you fail the crafting, you lose one of the components. So you have a chance to lose the scrap metal or the duct tape or the wood, but you also have a chance to lose the main weapon. For example, if you are crafting the percussion revolver, you have a chance to lose the percussion, if you want to craft the percussion revolver plus and you fail the craft, you have a chance of losing the percussion revolver or the scrap or the duct tape or the toolkit. So again, it's up to you if you want to cheese it or not, but just know that there is a chance you might lose the expensive items, but if you fail a craft, you lose only one item, so you can just lose the scrap, so no big deal, right? Again, I spoken a lot about the pistols and all the perks and such, so let's move on to the next one. Rifles and sniper rifles. So your basic rifle is of course the pipe rifle, which is terrible, but it's pretty easy to use and does decent damage in the beginning. The custom rifle, still terrible, but many improvements. You can only fire this one per combat, so that's the main thing you don't want to do, main disadvantage. But when you get to the magazine rifle with your perks, this will just be like a SKS. Actually, this will be much better than the SKS if you have the skills. Let's see, 11 to 17, 4. So that's how much, 11 to 17. The damage will mostly be the same because with the 20% extra damage, that will be the damage. 4%, yeah, it will be like the SKS, except that it will use only 4 action points to fire and 5 for an aim shot. But it has a lower magazine, so yeah. Anyway, the sniper rifle, this is the one you want to have. This will be comparable to the Dragunov sniper rifle. In some ways, I mean, the Dragunov is still better, but considering you can craft this rifle in the first few hours of the game, that's incredible. Besides, it only uses the 7.62 ammo, which is not so expensive and a lot easier to find than the sniper rifle ammo. So how do you craft it? Well, first you have to craft the pipe rifle, which again, I hope they sort this out, because as you can see, it's pretty hard to use the menu. They're not in order. So we have the pipe rifle, which is wood or a bat to scrap and duct tape. That's funny. And then you will have the custom rifle, which you will need the magnifying glass, which are a bit more expensive, but you should be able to manage. And then to craft the magazine rifle. Oh, where is this one? Oh, here it is. You'll need a piece of tire and some wire and some metal. Very, very easy to craft. And the final one, the sniper rifle, is actually even easier because you just need to have a toolkit. And as you can see, they are very, very cheap to produce. So in the end, I'll also show you the prices at the vendors, because if you have the weapons already and you have a better crafting skill chance, tinkering chance, then you might as well just craft all the junk into guns and sell them at the vendor. You can make a lot of money this way too. So crafting can give you very powerful, almost end game guns in the early game. can give you a lot of money, and it's a lot of fun to try out. Plus, with those new perks, I mean, again, you just have to take those perks, so that's one, three perks. Four, actually. That means you potentially have enough skill perk points left to take another two perks. Which, to be honest, will entirely depend to up to you. It will be up to you what you'll want to do, but you just might want to take the throwing if you go with crafting. I'll show you later why, because you can also craft a lot of grenades, and yeah, these weapons go very well because they have a low action point cost, so you can just toss a grenade and then fire a gun. So they go quite well with the throwing. Yeah, so that was the sniper rifle. Now let's go to the shotgun. The shotguns are a bit more interesting. You have the custom sawed-off shotgun, which, yeah, it only fires the ammo that you can craft, the crafted ammunition. And the crafted ammunition, if I remember correctly, is very, very weak. It almost does no piercing damage, so you don't want, you almost don't want to shoot at that armor enemies, but for the bandits it will shred them. So the custom sawed-off one is actually, it deals a lot of damage, but don't shoot at that armored enemies. And this is basically a one-time craft item, so this is not a real line. So to actually get a custom barrel, you need to go through the pipe rifle, the custom double barrel, which does a lot more damage. And it also uses the crafted ammunition. It also has the stun chance. This one does not has no stun chance. So custom double barrel, then you go to the three barrel gun, which has an interesting story, the Hydra Cerberus. And this is one of the cool guns from Resident Evil. I don't remember, but I think this is kind of like a throwback to Resident Evil. Correct me if I'm wrong. And again, stun chance is 5%, which is a lot higher. And it also uses the pellets, so it uses the regular shotgun ammunition. But you can only fire it once per turn. Unless you use the buffs, the drugs. Because it has 5 action cost to shoot, 2 to reload. So, depending on what you choose. But then you come to the really nasty shotgun. Oh, I love that one. So, let's see, the KC. 18 to 28, 4, 5, 4. 18 to 28. So the damage is... Well, you can fire all the bullets at once, which makes this a beast of a weapon. Let me demonstrate to you. It's 5 entries, so you can only shoot this gun once per turn. Yeah, let's get some shotgun shells in here. Equip it. This one I actually want to fire because I didn't get to experiment with it a lot. Let's see how much it So it fires four shotgun shells at the same time, so the KS can fire only twice per turn, and this one can fire basically four times, which means one thing. Hey, stand still. Ooh, that's a lot of damage, and it... Wow, only two shotgun shells were fired, because... Yeah. Okay, let's try it on the guards. I won't try them on the companions, because they have too much armor. So, this is metal armor, yes? So, you can't aim it, because if you could aim this one, it would be too powerful. So, let's see. I mean, it's almost a guaranteed stun or knockdown. So, it takes a little time for the game to calculate all the damage and all the impact. Yeah, there is no way someone can not get knocked out by this weapon. So this is basically an instant knockdown weapon, in case you're fighting something very, very strong. And you can actually get a little closer to them. Because it does have a short range. So, with my skill in rifle and shotguns, yeah, the range can be quite efficient. What? Are you kidding me? I can fire it? What? That's still a very long range. Come on. That's huge. I mean, you won't be able to use it because it will spread quite a lot, but still at that distance. Yeah, you have to use this gun at close range, even if it has a higher. Yeah, this is about the distance you want to be, the ideal distance, this or even closer. So it's, these guns are, actually can be a lot better than the regular ones, if you know how to use them, and the stun chance is 10%, so it's almost a guaranteed stun from this one. You can just use it as a backup weapon, let's say. Have the Dragon of like this, fire the Dragon of once, and if the enemy gets too close or you want to use the 4-barrel gun, shoot them. So fun, so much fun. Really, the last updates have really improved the game in so many ways that I'm left speechless sometimes. So let's give that back to Fidel. And we've covered the pistols, the sniper rifles and the shotguns. Shotguns are always funny. Again, that has 10% stun chance. I just can't get over that. Because the KS only has a stun chance. Yeah, it has 10% too, but again, it fires less bullets than that one. Less shotgun shells. Then you have the customer pistol, which is basically like a toy. Customer pistol, but I included it because it looks funny. It only shoots one bullet, so you need 5 action points to shoot one bullet, basically. Or to shoot 2 bullets, you need 7 action points. It's kind of a joke item, I don't know why they put it, and it also uses the pellet ammo. I don't know why they choose that. Next, I won't be speaking too much about the melee weapons, because I have spoken so much about them that it's not... I have another video for them, but to make the boom glove, you can get the recipes quite easy. The boom glove needs 3 battle gauntlets and the Makarov. But it needs those 3 battle gauntlets, and to make the battle gauntlets you need 2 leather gauntlets. Which, oh, actually they're spiked gloves. To be honest, I haven't found the spiked glove recipe, but I don't know, I'll just figure it out later. You can try to get the spike gloves from the merchants, they are not so hard to find. Usually you can find them in the caravans, and you can just buy 2 of them. I actually found one of them very easy in the game, so you know about them. I have them detailed in some other videos if you want to craft them for your melee. So you can actually get, again, all the items in the game are level locked behind the merchants, but if you craft them, you can have them at any time you want. I just don't know how to make the spike gloves. Maybe it's kind of an intuitive recipe, I don't know. We'll see. If I found it, I'll put it in the description if I find a recipe for the spike glove, okay? And then we can actually make all the crossbows now. So it's kind of a weird thing. You have the custom-made crossbow, which is not the wooden crossbow. So the custom-made crossbow is very weak. I don't recommend you craft it. It's super weak. It's too weak to even use. I mean, maybe if you are in the beginning of the game and want a weapon, but why would you do that? So the wooden crossbow is actually a lot better. And by a lot better, I mean a lot better. Even though it may seem like it's only 2 action points, 2 damage points difference. So you have the wooden crossbow, which is here. It only uses scraps and, by the way, they need rope and babushka hat, and that's not such a big difference. But then you have the metal crossbow, which should be somewhere. Come on, I really hope they fix this. Which will need 2 wooden crossbows, some scraps, and again some ropes. But the metal crossbows are actually the weapon that the bandits will be using. Now, before I speak more about the crossbows, just know that you have the bolts, which are wooden, and you have the metal bolts. Now, what is that bolt? So bolt, it's this one. And the metal bolt, well, it's metal and it uses kind of a lot of materials, and you get four of them, I think, once you craft them. Yeah, four of them. But the metal crossbow is actually better than the most guns in the game, because it has a lot of damage, 10 to 17, that's almost like an SKS. Of course, it doesn't have the critical chance, and you need to reload it after you shoot it once, so you can only shoot it once per turn, but again, it's a lot of damage. For a very low skill. By the way, they use throwing skill, and after that you have the heavy crossbow, which is one of the weapons I will just demonstrate because it's a lot of fun. But let's show you the recipes first. So I showed you those ones. So again, the custom made crossbow is weak, don't do it. Oh, come on, this is hard to figure out sometimes. Then you have the wooden crossbow. You can just find a lot of crossbows in the hands of the bandit, so I'm sure you won't have any problems with finding the metal crossbows first. The metal, but if you want to craft them, be my guest. And then you'll have the heavy crossbow, which uses two metal crossbows and either wires or rope. But again, it's an amazing weapon. Because with the piercing threshold of the metal bolts, you have about, yeah, it's kind of like a 0.30 armor piercing bullet. 16 to 26, and it has a critical chance of 10%. That's an important thing, and it can also use the aimed attack, so aim attack with a critical chance of 10%. This will be fun. But can I say it's a very little weapon, but it uses that throwing skill, so you kind of have to use the special perk tree. So this is in case you want to use crafted weapons, but not investing points in them. So they still get the crafted weapon damage bonus if you get this perk, but it's kind of not worth it in a way. You can just get the throwing. It doesn't say if this is only for grenades or also for the crossbow, but I suspect it's only for the grenades. But then again, I think the crossbows have a very long distance. I don't know, maybe they should change this. It's kind of like the distance of a assault rifle or something like that. 59 damage. They are very, very good. The crossbow is very good now. So if you do a single shot, oh, I missed all of the shots because I don't have my throwing skill very high. So let's do a single shot. The crossbow is just a beast. Too bad you don't see the crossbow ball sticking out of him. So crossbows are very, very good in this iteration of the game, and as I said, this is kind of the best weapon you can get in the first part of the game, so yeah, you can just, I don't know, this can be your primary weapon too. You just have to get close enough to score a clean shot with both of the bolts. 16 to 26. What is that dragon of that? I want to compare it. So it does even more damage than the Dragunov, and it has a higher critical chance than the Dragunov. This has the potential to be one of the best weapons in the game. It's so easy to craft. You can craft it in the first hour, basically. Such an amazing weapon. Okay, let's go on, because I still have to show you some other crafting recipes. To be honest, most of them are not really worth it, but I just want to show the F1 grenade. You can use the training grenades to make F1 grenades, really nice and easy. You can also use the homemade grenade. I'll show you them. This is the homemade grenade, by the way. It's 15 to 25 with a stun chance, and it uses 6 action points to throw, so it's not ideal, but what can you do? Now, where is the other type? So this is the homemade grenade, so custom hand grenade. The custom hand grenade is the one that uses the gunpowder, but this can be mass produced. Stun chance is still 20%, so you can throw them in the beginning of a combat. They don't do a lot of damage, but they have that stun chance and they can be really good in the beginning. Because you can just mass produce them. Homemade grenade. And it's only using gunpowder and the tin can. So it can be a lot of fun. Other than that, I mean, these weapons are really, really deadly. The deadliest weapons in the game are the homecrafted ones. Because even though the other weapons are still very good, they are locked behind the level cap. They are very, very expensive to get. They have very expensive ammunition, and what can I say? Oh, by the way, this is the knife that I didn't have in the beginning. So now I actually know how to get all the items in the game, all the new items. So this is the recipe for the knife knuckle duster. But to be honest, it's a very bad weapon. It has the 4 action points cost, which is not better than the Taiga. So the Taiga is the better weapon, because it also has the chance of cause panic. But this one has the chance to stun, 10% chance to stun, so 10% to cause panic, but panic is, I don't know, it's up to you if you want to stun or panic. Oh, this is a martial weapon. Okay, so this uses the martial arts, so this is melee, this is martial arts skill. Anyway, this has been my crafting video, and this is all the recipes you can get. I mean, these are the most useful recipes you can get. You can also have some other, like the 3-barrel gun and stuff like that. But you really want to get the shotgun, the 4-barrel shotgun, the heavy crossbow, the percussion revolver plus, and of course the sniper rifle. Maybe some grenades, maybe the boom glove, if you really want to have fun with it. I show this a lot of times and it's a lot of fun with the critical chance plus 15% stun chance. And if you take the martial arts road, it's quite a fun weapon. Whew, that was a lot of explaining and showing stuff. I hope you liked it. If you have any questions, just ask. I think this is basically all the best crafting you can get right now. See you next time. Bye.